came out, it was shortlisted for the Blue Peter Prize. And I was so excited because they told me that on TV they were going to have these, they're going to animate it, they're going to have this little section, short video that they were going to make animating a little scene from my book. And I mean, wow, Blue Peter, I'm going to get a badge and all these things. And so I waited for this to happen. I waited for the Blue Peter announcement, and they were going to talk about the shortlist, and they're going to show this video about my book. And the video came out. And just to give you a little bit of background, my book is about a little girl growing up in London. Her mom is a Filipino working in a hospital, and she has a brother in the Philippines that she's never met. And the story is about the brother finally getting a visa to come to England. But when he turns up, he's 8 foot tall. He's a giant. Okay, so that's the story. The video shows the moment when they meet at the airport. The little girl's there waiting at the airport. And then along comes, this is all they're animated. Along comes the brother off the plane, and he's white. This was on Blue Peter, and I was so shocked. I wrote my agent, my publisher. I was really, really upset. And they were embarrassed, and they fixed it. So the next time it showed, my character Bernardo was brown. But it was so telling. It was like my first realization. I mean, I knew that there was some problem with diversity, but actually my journey to publication had nothing to do with race or, it was, I got published. And I was thinking, well, then I'm going to be treated like an author. But I didn't expect that there would be this assumption that if I had a hero, that hero would have to be somebody with white skin.